So I have just one more question, and then we'll go to questions from the audience. And this one doesn't come from the man who we will not name. It comes from Juno Diaz, which you know, who I hope you can all appreciate. So Juno Diaz actually wrote a response to Harbach. And I'm going to read you an excerpt, and then I'd just be interested in your thoughts on it. So Juno Diaz writes, "Lately I've been reading about MFA versus New York City, but for many of us, it's MFA versus POC, which stands for persons of color." He goes on to write, "I didn't have a great MFA workshop experience, not at all. In fact, by the start of my second year, I was like, get me the fuck out of here. So what was the problem? Oh, just the standard problem of MFA programs. That shit was too white." True of MFA programs, true of New York publishers, equally true of both. What do you think?
Sometimes.
Yeah, I guess that, what I know of them, yes, it's my experience.
I think that, yeah, probably it's true. Also, I think that's a really healthy attitude for anyone of any color in the workshop. There are times when it's best to say, you know what, this is all kind of bullshit. Everything we're doing here. There's a good, I mean, you have to keep your own personal vision strong as well. And times that students and, you know, his reasons have to do with race, and probably, I think in that same article he mentions class a little bit. But those are real limitations to not just MFA programs, but education in general. And I think it's good for students, all kinds of students, at some point to look around and to say, you know what, I kind of don't care what the instructor says today. I've kind of had it with this. And to kind of clear their head. And yeah, I think that's a pretty smart response.
Yeah, I think you should be totally sick of your MFA program.
By the end of it?
Yeah, I think it is bullshit, and I don't want to be done with this. And then go, I mean, I think this is part of the, some of the stuff that gets brought up is that then you go serve your apprenticeship, and that's probably going to be another 5 years before you actually do discover who you are as a writer and what you want to do, and that it isn't, you know, as soon as you graduate with your MFA that you should have a book deal. I think it really is spending some time going and figuring out what you want to do. Taking in all those voices from your instructors and classmates and understanding how to read your own work, but then like going away and just, you know, you were talking about going and living, getting life experience and doing that. I think that's really important.
I think at Iowa, we were the women of the program were a little bit discouraged because it was kind of the stuff that was really lauded often was what we called dick lit. And but it was something, it was interesting because it was something to kind of push against. And I found this thesis in the libraries by Sandra Cisneros, and it was her poetry thesis that was rejected. And because it was housed on Mango Street, I think, and so it wasn't considered poetry. But so the women of the program were just kind of thinking, you know, okay, if Cisneros can have a hard time here, then we're doing the right thing. And I wrote to her after the program, and I told her what, you know, kind of what a beacon she was for us, and how important it was that we had known about her experience. She was not happy at the workshop, and there was, you know, a lot of that. But she went on, and she was, you know, she became her writer. She became Sandra Cisneros. She was a wonderful, wonderful writer, very unusual, different at the time. And she wrote back, and she said, she was always grateful for that experience at Iowa because it made her name herself as a writer. And I think that just always was to stay with me, because regardless of your experience or the larger, you know, kind of waves or, you know, what's popular at the time, you have to find your own voice, and it gives you the opportunity to do that. And if there's, you know, that people are writing a lot of Diglett and trying to sound like Updike or whatever. You can do whatever you need to do.
It's a lovely affirming note to close on. So.